All right. Remember I said that I probably wasn't going to do this game. But obviously I lied. So here it is. And this is Mega Man 4. For those who don't know, it'll become immediately apparent in a few seconds. It starts out with a little cutscene that actually explains the origins of Mega Man. Because oddly enough, they've never been explained up to this point. You just know that you are a fighting robot, and you were named Mega Man, and you were fighting Wily. So this explains how it all happened. Wily took the robots, drove them mad, started destroying the city, conquering the world, and nobody knew what to do. And then Dr. Light had his assistant, little boy robot, Rock, and he volunteered to be a fighting robot for justice. America. So then, he turned him into Mega Man. And then, the rest is history. So, they don't explain at all what the fuck is happening in the story of this game. Just that, it's all that they do. Just that you're Mega Man, and you fucked up Wily's shit 3 times. And, peace is not going to last because shit keeps happening. Oh wait, okay, there it is. It did explain. A mysterious scientist has invented 8 powerful robots, and he wanted to kill Mega Man from the nefarious Russian engineer Dr. Kosak, who is totally not Dr. Wily. And I'm not even being sarcastic. He's totally not Dr. Wily. I know when I played Mega Man 6, it was totally Dr. Wily. And when I played Mega Man 5, it was totally Dr. Wily. But this time, it's totally not Dr. Wily. It's totally Dr. Kosak. But it is Wily after Kosak. There's two guys. You're going to figure that out. So let's start things up. Here we go. Now, this game is really fucking hard. It's like the hardest of all the old Mega Mans. So there's no easy way to do this. You just have to fucking man up, muscle your way through it. So I don't know why I'm not clicking these lives. I'm jumping right on them. They're just fucking disappearing from existence as soon as they appear, I guess. That's how quicksand works. So I'm fighting these scorpion / vacuum cleaners in quicksand. And I gotta make this jump. I don't want to fuck it up. Damn it. There you go. Yay for not being useless. So I'm going this way because there's totally a hidden item over here. That's right, this game has hidden items. Oh no. Oh, I'm such an idiot. Guy was on my side. I got the B. Whatever that is. It's an item I probably won't use very much. But it can come in handy if you want to use it. Do you remember how Mega Man 1 through 3 had, really just Mega Man 3, you had the rush items, but then before Mega Man 3, you had the regular items in Mega Man 2. And they were basically like rush, but inferior. So in this game, you have, you got the rush items, and you have the other items, but you don't get the other items automatically. You have to go find them, like the thing I just picked up. So what I picked up was the balloon. And it's basically like, I think it was item 1 in Mega Man 2 that had the little floating platforms that you just spawn out of nowhere. They're exactly like that, except they're balloons. And balloons are cool, I guess. Whatever. These balloons are kind of cool. But you never really need to use them, which is why they're optional. They can come in handy, though, in some situations where climbing puzzles are a pain in the ass. So I've managed to get to the lair of the evil Pharaoh Man, which is one of the coolest fucking bosses Mega Man has ever had. I mean, Pharaoh Man seems like a really weird name, but I mean, just look at this fight. He's a fucking beast, and he looks really fucking cool. Everything's kind of Egyptian, all kinds of crazy shit going on. The name doesn't really make sense, but he's cool. and he's challenging. And you could fight him with the, whatchamacallit, the, you'll kill Brightman, take Brightman's move, and kill him with that, because it freezes him in place, and you can just wail on him for 20 minutes and he's dead. However, you saw that fight went by really fast. I was just wailing on him the entire time, while trying to impotently dodge all of his just clusterfuck of shit he's throwing at me and jumping around and stuff. So, it was kind of kill him before he kills me. But, the reason why I killed him first is because his weapon's totally awesome. And because if I had the ability to kill him, you know, his weakness, the fight wouldn't have really gone any faster. And this is, I'm trying to make this go as fast as possible. So, here we go. That's a little trick, a little pro tip. Get up there, you can bypass a few seconds of time by sliding up there when you, right as soon as you hit the ground. There we go. This stage is all kind of types of annoying bullshit, because these platforms will disappear and just all these fucking enemies all over the place. They're not even designed to be hard, they're just designed to be annoying. You could totally kill them one way or the other, but I could probably pull out the Pharaoh attack and kill him right now. But I'd like to save a few nuggets of Pharaoh energy, at least to kill Ringman, because it's his weakness, that's kind of why I'm here. There you go. Let's see if I can kill this guy real quick. I'm not sure. Trying to fuck up. There we go. Here's some energy. There. That wasn't so bad. That was kind of fast. Certainly seemed a lot faster than if I had killed him the normal way. Which is why this Pharaoh attack, the Pharaoh shot, I guess it is fucking awesome. Because it's omnidirectional. Or at least kinda. It doesn't go straight up, I think. That's the one weakness. Can't kill enemies right directly above you. I'm kinda wasting energy right here, but I don't give a fuck. This has to be faster than... Come on, man. Quit fighting like a bitch. That's the thing that's crazy about this stage. This stage has to be like the hardest of the... or at least one of the hardest of all the regular stages. Very, you know, the pacing is so weird, because this is the third fucking mini-boss I've had to fight. What the fuck is going on here? I mean, most of Mega Man, like, you fight one or two, and that's it. You're done. But I've already had to fight three, and I'm gonna have to fight another one. It's ridiculous. I could've used one if I want, but I'm gonna use that. Why not? Why the fuck not? And mildly useful. Probably gonna die before I get to the end of this anyway. Totally ruined my life, have to start over. This game is totally fucking hard. Oh well. So this is the most annoying thing. You gotta do this just right. You gotta slide your ass off, or you gotta go real fast and you know, I played this game in the way to, you know, where I avoid all the special, I avoid the two special items, which is the balloon and the wire. But now that I have them, I'm realizing that I could make my game so much easier to play if I just fucking use them. Because I played this game like, you know, thinking that I'd only have Rush Coil, and I'm still falling in the same old bad habits. Come on. The timing on this guy is so ridiculous. It seems to change. And now I'm gonna die. Aha! I've hit a checkpoint. Excellent. So, I wanted to do a run of this game where I don't die. But I don't think it's fucking possible. At least not from me. I don't love this game enough to make it possible. I can do it with a lot of other games, but I'm not going to do it with this one. So, deal with it. Let's try to kill this guy in an orderly fashion. This is not going very orderly. This is actually going very disorderly. It's pissing me off. This is actually one of my least favorite bosses to fight, because he's just so fucking hard. He's got so much shit that he throws at you. And it's just non-stop. And he adapts. He adapts for how you're running around. You know, if you stop, then he fucking stops. It pisses me off. It's a crazy Mega Man X type of boss. Because Mega Man X bosses, they do the same shit. But you can jump up the walls. You can escape. You can't escape in Mega Man 4. I will admit, this is pretty cool. Fucking little cutscenes where you get the items. This crazy animation going on. That's where the budget went. This game goes all out. I mean, you compare it to Mega Man 5. Mega Man 5 is pretty cool, but all around, it seems a lot cheaper than this game does. So that's to this game's credit. Now, this stage fucking sucks. And I don't say that because it's hard. I don't say that because it's cheap. And I don't say it because it has, like, craziest of death spikes. Though it kind of does, but not really. And I don't even say it because these fucking pissant fucking things that come out of the ground, come out of these open pits for no fucking reason, and ruin your life. And they appear, like, literally, like, maybe one other place in the entire game. So they're just there to piss you off for the rest of the time you're playing this game. Just like these guys. But the reason why this level fucking sucks is because of something that's gonna pop up very shortly. You remember, like, it becomes a trope almost, where it's in a few select areas of other Mega Man games, where you have just a big room with the ceiling that retracts, and you have to just shoot all the dust particles out of the way so you can progress forward. And it pisses me off, because it's a stupid fucking idea. Just, all it does is make the game slow and choppy and extend the length of these levels. Because, I mean, you sit there and, like, measure it out how fast I'm beating most of these levels in all the games. Even Mega Man X. I could beat the game, the levels. Look at this shit. Fucking glitched the med tool. This is ridiculous. And you can't even see all the way across. And your bullets don't hit because the fucking NES is stupid physics. Or lack thereof, really. They didn't know what physics was in 1986. So look at this bullshit. And then, you have to slide there, no problem. There's another fucking wall of dust. How is this fun? This isn't even challenging. It's just, oh, I have to slide over there and then shoot two bullets and come back and do that like 10 times and then, okay. In all fairness, I should have been dead. Instant death, by the way. But I broke the system. And if there is ever a time to break the system where it's worth it, it's totally, you know, it's totally fucking understand. Look at this shit. That's fucking crazy bug that I hate with this system. You saw I turn around at the last minute, it hits me in the back, and I fall off to the spikes, and I almost kill myself. It wasn't for my invincibility power. I hate respawning enemies. You take, like, literally one step, and it's back. Just one of the things I like about 3D gaming is that the camera follows you, and not follows a sliced path on the side that doesn't make any sense. So that nothing can respawn right in front of your fucking face. Now, this guy is not my favorite boss. I hate him. And he's not hard. He's not even challenging. He's not even remotely interesting. He just sits there and stays invincible for the entire fight. For like 5 minutes. He just sits there. Won't let you hit him. There's not any, like, grace period where you can fucking... Nope. Just completely bounces off. This is like the fifth time in a row he's done that. I mean, their AI is kind of random, but come on, man. What do I have to do? I don't... Like, you're not hard. I just want to end this. None of the other bosses do this bullshit. Except Drill Man. Drill Man's a fucking cunt. Hate his ass. He's almost worse, because he just disappears off the fucking face of the planet. And arbitrarily appears like 5 seconds later. This game brings up a lot of bad memories. Dust Crusher. What the fuck are you gonna crush with dust? Well, skulls, obviously. Make these skulls all dirty, and that's their ultimate weakness. Because skeletons, bones are not afraid of, I don't know, fire, or archaeologists, or any, I don't know what would damage bone, acid. No, they're afraid of dirt. Dirt's their ultimate weakness. Just dirt. Which, this is why they call him Dust Man. He's basically just a big vacuum cleaner. He's more like Anti-Dust Man in that sense. But it would be so much worse if he was called Dirt Man. No one would respect him remotely. I took the wrong way. They're fucking misleading alternate paths that are not really alternate paths. They're just brick walls that you don't know about. Another one. But at least I got rid of that guy. So that was cool. Fucking glitched that system. Just slide my way across. Like a professional athlete up in this bitch. What's up, Eddie? Thanks for nothing, buddy. So, which way do I go? Do I go straight ahead for no apparent reason? It took like 10 minutes to get maybe an E-tank. Or do I skip ahead? I'm gonna skip ahead. Now, this game, unlike the other Mega Man games, Mega Man 3, remember there was a lot of E-tanks across that you could get. And, I never even used them. Because, I thought the game was too easy. But I played the shit out of that fucking game, so that's... God damn it. I thought I could pass it. I've done it before, but... Was it to be? Fuck you. I'm not even gonna give you the satisfaction of coming back and kill your ass. But now that there's three of you, I kinda can't avoid it anymore. So, there you go. Oh, thought you were gonna hit me, but you didn't. Reform my life. I don't even need it on my life. I don't even want it. Fuck it. Pull up my dust. My dirt. Dirt shot. You'd think it would be a damaging weapon to be using as Mega Man. Because, you know, all the art, he seems pretty clean. Seems pretty on the ball with his maintenance. Except for, God. This is what I hate this guy. Because he dies real quick. But if he hits you once, you're halfway dead. That's why they call him Skullman, I guess. He's a headhunter. And there's a fucking kick-ass dinosaur right there. That would be a good boss. Fucking T-Rex or something. Like, just skeletized T-Rex. Because we've had dragons. Dragons are cool. I'm not gonna shit on dragons. But,